Historical background. Zephaniah, Nahum, and Habakkuk lived and prophesied in a very difficult period of the southern kingdom's history. This period was between 650 to 600 BC and was characterized by political instability brought about by the shifting of political power between Assyria, Egypt, and Babylon. The schism of the Kingdom of Israel in 922 BC created a certain vacuum in the international politics of the Near East, which Assyria was quick to take advantage of. The 8th century BC saw the rise of Assyria as the superpower of the Near East. Under kings Tiglath-Pileser III, Shalmaneser V, Sargon II, and Sennacherib. Tiglath-Pileser III conquered Samaria in 721 BC and took its inhabitants into exile. King Ahaz of the Southern Kingdom made a treaty with Tiglath-Pileser III in 735 BC. Thus, the Southern Kingdom became a vassal of Assyria. His successor, King Hezekiah, tried to rebel but was quickly brought under submission. Assyria reached its zenith of power and strength under Kings Esharaddon, who ruled from 680 to 669 BC. He conquered Memphis in 671. And the other king, Ashurbanipal, who ruled from 668 to 621 BC, who conquered and destroyed Thebes in 663 BC. After King Ashurbanipal's death, the Assyrian Empire broke up. It is during this time, 7th century BC, that Zephaniah, Nahum, and Habakkuk prophesied. Zephaniah seems to hint at the Scythian uprising at the eastern border of the Assyrian Empire, implying its doom. He is normally assigned to the time before Josiah's reforms in 622 BC. Nahum is active in the prophetical ministry before the fall of Nineveh, the capital of Assyria, 612 BC, as it is this destruction that he predicts. Habakkuk seems to be a contemporary of Nahum.